In this video, Elon Musk admits he owns Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Dogecoin. Same goes with SpaceX, they are currently holding Bitcoin. And on top of that, we need to check out for this next major move that can affect the whole market, both in the long term as well as in the short term. Stay tuned to know more. So hi guys, and welcome back to another Cubs cryptocurrency video where we trade by data and not by hype. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, click the subscribe button down below and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out daily technical analysis like this. And yeah, meron din ako guys na free Ethereum giveaway. So if you haven't heard, I'm giving away free Ethereum. So if you want to join this giveaway, you can actually find this Google form in the description down below. Sali lang kayo guys if gusto nyo. You just have to follow some of these criterias. So let's dive into this video. So initially, our latest technical analysis was following this bullish divergence. So we broke out from the bullish divergence and hit this 50 moving average. And what I've told you, this might play around this moving average, but not unless if you break either the 50, either the 100 or the 50 moving average. So right now we broke that moving average and now we are seeing that pump that we have been waiting for. And on top of that, we actually saw some hype coming in from this Bitcoin movement, but it was actually rejected due to a bearish divergence forming. So as you can see, despite of Elon Musk bringing up the price of Bitcoin, it will still go down. It's because of this increasing price and the declining RSI. And as you all know, guys, that is a bearish divergence. So either way, this will always trend reverse. This will always traverse to the downside if we are going to see some bearish analysis such as like this. So ayun guys, take note that the price of Bitcoin will always be dependent too on the technical analysis. So let's find out what's the next move for Bitcoin. So actually for the Bitcoin next price action, we are actually following this symmetric triangle, and symmetric triangle is a 50-50 decisive move. So if it breaks to the upside, we could actually see a pump to up at least 32.8k target, or if you break to the downside, we could actually see a 31.2k level. So definitely a level to watch out for. So if this breaks with volume, remember, in order to confirm a move, this must have volume, because if there's no volume, this can lead to a fake out or a resistance. So if this breaks with volume, you had to follow those levels. Pero if we did not see any volume, we could actually see some support at this 31.5k level or a resistance at the 32.5k level. So targets are the 32.8k for bullish and 31.2k for bearish. And then our major support line would be the 31.5k and the 32.5k for resistance, as well as this moving average. So yeah, definitely a level to watch out for. And by the time that I post this video, I think this might have broken out already. So if you don't want to miss signals like this, I actually posted this earlier at our Facebook, Telegram, and Discord group. You can actually find the link in the description below. So if you want to join and don't want to miss signals like this, you can join our group. But yeah, because of this movement, we actually saw a massive pump for both Ethereum, Cardano, SLP, Axie Infinity. So as you can see, it's always dependent on the price of Bitcoin. So right now, we are seeing those massive pumps happening exactly as what I've been telling you guys. Lahat sila independent pa rin kay Bitcoin regardless. Pero right now, for SLP, on top of different technical analysis for different coins, we are actually seeing this major resistance for SLP, which is this level of this Fibonacci of 34 cents. And we actually tested that twice. In fact, we also got a bearish divergence forming. So this is an increasing price. And then right here, we have a declining RSI, which indicates that it's a trend reversal to the downside. So our next major support would be this Fibonacci level of around 28 cents or 29 cents. But yeah, moving average are the levels to watch out for this possible rejection. However, if Bitcoin decides to pump in this area, of course, SLP will pump. Pero if Bitcoin will dump, of course, SLP will dump too. Now, let's now move to this next Bitcoin chart that I believe we should be following. So previously, I have shown you a video regarding this RSI resistance that we should have been following in order to flip bullish. So if we break this resistance, that's where we are going to see a bullish movement for Bitcoin. And right now, today, we are currently testing this exactly. So right now, what Bitcoin must now do is either to break this line or possibly hold this as a support. It's because if history is any indication, you can see that there are multiple instances where we are getting a strong rejection from this RSI resistance. And if we get a rejection from this price action in the RSI, Bitcoin might still dump even lower and go down to again this, and might even continue this strong support that we have been following for the Bitcoin price. So Bitcoin must now either break this RSI resistance or at least hold support within this yellow line. So if we are going to follow this yellow line, our breakout would might be extended up until around August 7 if you're going to follow the RSI movement. So this is a very longer time frame. So this is a longer time frame, so definitely a level to watch out for if we get rejected by this RSI resistance. But if we get resisted, of course, Bitcoin and other altcoins will be affected by this movement. So right now we are still holding this strong support, and take a look at this, guys. On our previous video, I have told you na itong weekly time frame. This weekly time frame is very crucial, as in our previous dead cross, we have held support from this red line. And right now, Bitcoin is holding a strong support as this red line still. It's because during a bull market, we have never seen Bitcoin drop below this red line, which is the 50-week moving average. And right now, we are still holding this. So as long as Bitcoin holds this line up until next week, I believe we are still healthy for Bitcoin. And as you can see, ito yung sinasabi ko sa inyo na kahit magkaroon siya ng dump, as long as the weekly candle close stays within this level, we might still see a rebound for Bitcoin. Pero yun nga, if this close below the red line, that's where we are going to see the continuation of a midterm bear market. And right now we are not seeing that yet kasi nga we are still at this red line. So kaya sinasabi ko sa inyo, guys, na wag kayo magsell kasi not everything is confirmed, and what if nagkaroon bigla ng trend reversal din ang pag-iwanan ka? So this is why I keep on telling you na instead of selling, what you should be focusing is on buying and dollar cost averaging your position. Kasi one thing's for sure, bull market can make you money, but bear markets can make you rich. Kasi of course, you are maximizing this compounding profit. So now, Bitcoin is currently healthy as long as we sustain and break the RSI strong resistance, and as long as we sustain this 50-week moving average. So now let's dive into Elon Musk. So makikita niyo yung video ni Elon Musk kahapon on the interview for Bitcoin. We actually heard Elon Musk saying that Tesla is, of course, we all know Tesla owns Bitcoin, but right now this is what we haven't heard. SpaceX now also owns Bitcoin, and Elon Musk admits he owns Bitcoin. Same goes with Ethereum and Dogecoin. So that is actually big news kasi we haven't had any confirmation or direct confirmation from his words itself na meron talaga siyang Bitcoin. So with that being said, does that affect anyhow of the short-term and long-term movement? For the long term, I don't think so. Kasi, of course, Bitcoin is always dependent on the overall volume and the technicals. So I don't believe that this can affect the whole market itself for the long term. Pero in the short term, we actually saw nga itong pump na nakita natin. Pero short-lived lang yung pump. But yeah, sabi ko sa inyo, guys, hindi masyado dependent ang market sa mga hype. Short term lang yung mga hype niya, and then it will eventually go down. Pero if you're going to understand this, SpaceX now also bought Bitcoin. I believe if that's the case, then could this be the reason why nakita tayo ng pump dyan? Could it be na SpaceX entered at this area? Or do you think Tesla or Elon Musk in general bought Bitcoin at this area? Same goes with Ethereum. So who knows? So definitely this is a big news for the whole crypto space kasi of course previously we saw Elon Musk being negative on Bitcoin, but today he is very bullish and supports it actually. So in the end, I believe na despite of the hype coming in, of course Elon Musk can help this price go up, pero for the short term lang yon. Yes, and as long as big personality supports Bitcoin, I think the adoption will continue, and of course this will hold a strong foundation for Bitcoin for the future, and of course it will also help us remain bullish, of course, kasi nga the more that big personalities are supporting Bitcoin, the more na may adoption, the more na magiging stable ang ating future for the Bitcoin price. So if you find this video useful and informative, please give this video a like, and if you want to see more contents like this, please subscribe for more. I'll see you in the next video, and bye bye for now.